We're at SF MoMA, and we're looking at a Jackie Windsor sculpture. This is called Number One Rope. It dates to 1976. It's made out of square wood rods.
And there are seven in each row.
So seven by seven.
Seven squared.
And they're vertical, and they're holding three balls of hemp, which are roughly wound into tight spheres.
I found myself wondering while we looked at this, what was holding it together? Because each stick seems very separate, and yet clearly they're linked in some way also by horizontal bars that we can't see.
Or you can barely see it. And
see.
I think, in fact, perhaps you're not even supposed to see.
Right. But so it has a kind of mysteriousness to its being able to stand up.
At the same time, they almost seem to have a kind of gravity that holds them together.
It's so interesting that she's using these found materials and transforming them. I found myself immediately imagining the gesture of the winding. I knit, so I often make skeins of yarn, and it takes a really long time to wind this much.
So there's real labor involved here.
It feels that way, yeah. Also the movement of the hand to make the skeins.
And so one wonders what purpose these skeins, in a sense, hold, because there almost feels like there's an industrial purpose, as if they are going to go onto a loom of some sort. But it's so interesting because we're thinking about the mechanized, and there is something mechanized here
in the grid.
But on the other hand, there's something that's so tactile and handmade.
Yeah, and it's looking back at a kind of tradition of woman's work, perhaps. We also notice the rough texture and the way that the hemp is coming apart a little bit compared with the pieces of wood that seem so solid.
And then, of course, there's a square hole in the center.
There is.
There's this absence.
It takes a minute to notice it.
Yeah, but there's darkness there, and it draws our eye in, and then you want to rise up on your toes and look in a little bit, and this is something a little mysterious, and how is that shaped, and does the square go all the way down, and does it expand out in that middle layer, perhaps? There's something unknown and kind of unknowable about this.
Yeah, I think there's a real sense of time because of that element that we were talking about of how long
each...
So that it's a work that embodies a long duration and work and repetitive work.
But they come together in this kind of extraordinary sense of unity. I mean, together, the 7x3, this unit, they feel so solid and so interdependent.
But each one is different, right?
They are totally different, yeah.
Yeah,
the
you
windings
start really
are completely
noticing
different.
How each one is different. The coloration is different and the winding is different.
No, it's almost like thatch. I mean, it's this beautiful organic material. And, of course, it's gotten dirty over time, but it's not precious at all. And yet it feels solid and strong.
And the making of it feels like it involved a lot of energy.
And that if one were to ever try to unmake this, it would take an extraordinarily long period of time.
Exactly.